The worksheet is one of the most important things in SigmaPlot NG. And here, we look at an overview of the worksheet. To start with studies into the worksheet, you can come into File, and then, head over to Options. Under Options, the first tab here is for Worksheet. Here is where you can preset the worksheet and you have the option for numeric values in here, the appearance of the worksheet and also, the original settings. For numeric, you can change the display. So now it's engineering notation, but when needed, you can use fixed decimals or general as well. And then, you can also change the decimal places too, by clicking for a drop-down. To select one decimal place or two decimal places, you do that here. And then you can also come to the appearance. Over here, the default size for the cells is 64 by 24. But that can be changed here. And then also, the grid adjustments can be made. The grid color is none, but you can come in and choose from these options and customize the worksheet. Also the thickness is thin, however, you can change it to medium or thick and other options too. And then, for the font style, you can change it to any of these ones that have been provided. Lastly, here is the size of the font itself within the cell. Once you're done, you click OK, and then close out. The worksheet is similar to any spreadsheet where you have cells. Here, there is A1, there is B1, there is A2, B2, and you have all of that in here. And then, you can also come over to the Worksheet tab on the menu bar. So here, there are many options to play with the worksheet and we will go through them. But before we go through them, let's upload the notebook that we built. So let's head over to File, and then Open. And then let's open Learn. And then under Learn, let's come into Data 1, and this opens. Close this Notebook 1, and select No. We have Learn, and under Learn, we have Chapter 1, Chapter 2, and all of these here. We have this sample data. Let's close out all of these ones. The same way we did the File and Open. You can also come into File Import as well. And that is the first tab that we see here for Import, where you can import a file. When you want to import data into current worksheet, you can do that easily from Excel, or you can import from some of the extensions provided. There are different extensions to import from, like JMP, MATLAB, R. Or anywhere that you have the data, you can import it into the worksheet. And then you also have database or import database into the current worksheet. You can import from JDBC or ODBC. And then, you have the edit. Over here, there is the regular copy and paste. You can highlight this and select copy. And then you can come in here and select paste. You can use the regular keyboard shortcuts as well. If you type Ctrl plus V, Ctrl plus C, Ctrl plus X for cut, that works. And then you can also clear any content that you want. If you select this one, and you can select, and clear to go away. Then in our regular interface, we can also use Find. You can do 1.0000, and then select Find, and then it finds any match. You can replace it with something else, you can replace all, you can replace some of it. If want to replace the ones with 1.1, and then you select Replace. Then this changes to 1.1, and then you can also replace all. You can match entire cell text, you can match case and many others. Sorting through data is available here. Let's come in here to sort. First, you have to select a column and then head over to sort. You can come in and sort column number, if you selected multiple columns. If you select all your columns, and then you come to sort. Then choose I want to sort this one, I want to sort it from ascending to descending order, or any choice of yours. If I choose descending, then you can sort, the biggest comes first, and then the smallest, go last now. And then you can also come back and just change that as well, it flips back. Then the column title. I already added the titles here, thus you can just come in and select column title. You have promote row to title. So you can promote row 1. If you copied your data and you had the names in row 1, you can actually promote it to title, or you can promote any row into a title. If you want to promote row 8, you can just type 8 to a title, and then you can do that as well. And then also for titles you can double-click in here, and then edit this title here. You can also double-click in here, and delete and change the title as well. So that is it for edit. You can come over here and right-click, and you have filter. You have sort, you have custom sort if you want to do a custom sort and many others in here. And then you head over to the cell. For the cell region, this is where you edit the cell. If you select cell, you can also come in and change the font. For the font size, you can multiple select, and then change the font size. You can make it bold, you can make it italic, underline, you can strike through it. You can wrap extra long ones. You can also change the font color here too. If you select, this changes. If you drop this one down, you can change or use the color that you want. And then you can change the background color of the cells too. If you want to change the background color, you can also do that here. Regularly, you can align horizontally, align vertical. You can add borders like we have in our regular Excel. You can add borders and a table comes in. You can align vertical. You can align to the center. You can align to the top. Also the horizontal, you can align to the left. You can align to the right, you can align to the center. You can also come into format. Select format like we did before. And then remember, if you go to options, you see this. You can change the type, what is in the cell, to numeric, and then change that if you put it to text. You can wrap if it's a date, if it's a currency, if it's a percentage or accounting. And then, for rows and columns, you can also change that here as well. You can also insert graphics into your cells. So let's come in here and select graphics cell. First, you can add a color. We add green and then it changes to green. Then, for the next one we want to add yellow. I think I added white, so yes, let's add yellow now and then you can add blue. You can add colors to your cells and then if you come to the next one, you can add lines to your cells. If you want to add this line, you want to add that, and then you want to add that, and then you can also add shapes to your cells so you can do that. You can do that. You can do that. Under calculations, the first one is formulas. If you select a cell, and then you select formulas, Sigmaplot and G already have many formulas inbuilt for you, and you can use it on your data. And then, you can also come to the side and choose which type or which category it falls under. So if it's statistical, then you have the statistical formulas already inbuilt for you. So here, you also see that there is a formula bar where you can actually write your own formula in. And then you can also hide or show it. So now it's hidden, but if you click on this it will show. You can come in here, and go to formula, and choose average, and then select OK. Let's average this one. Select from A1 to A10 and that highlights. And then you close the bracket. And then select Enter. That gives you that average right there. In future lessons, we will look at analysis and there are some transforms and user-defined functions that we'll build. Once you build some of these ones, they will appear here when you come to your formulas. You can use them accordingly on the columns as well. Finally, you can also freeze pane and freeze this one like you have, and when you scroll, you still have a title being shown. In a nutshell, this worksheet is customizable, editable, and you can make it very neat as you desire.